Oh, God. Well, that's not a great start to a video. All right, so I'm hearing heat and also map gas. Thank you, Douglas Marshall. That will be the next thing I try, but I think the only place where I get that is closed for today. So I'm going to try. I'm going to see how long it takes to heat this thing up. And, Jesus, I got to sit here like this until this thing pops out. Evidently, aluminum is going to expand faster than steel. The bearing is steel. So I'm going to heat up this aluminum, I don't even know what it's called, a hubcap, wheel cover. So, pressed bearings are a pain. So I'm going to stay around here on the side because I don't want to, I want to heat up the bearing. As far as damaging the bearing, I'm not worried about that because the bearing is already shot. And in case you didn't see, well, I don't know if I put this in another video, but there was a rock that got right in here next to the bearing seal. It was just rolling around in there, got stuck. You see some damage on the on our cover here, the wheel cover plate. And destroyed the seal, which means if any grit or anything gets in there, it destroys the balls in the races. Is that what they're called? So, I'd be surprised if the paint on here doesn't, like, come off first. Yeah, you can see how long this takes. And take up Google services, servers. It's more useless crap. I can just tell you what the time is later, but if you do have to go through this, this will give you an idea of what you're in for. I've tried other things. but you really do have to expand the aluminum and just let it drop. And the bearing that I'm going to replace it with, I need to put that in the freezer. And if I do that, it should drop right in. So, but I guess if this drops right out from the other bearing, I shouldn't have to put it in the freezer. To do both, the other setup that I had, and yeah, that's not budging at all. If I could prop this up high enough, I could use a propane torch. But according to Douglas Marshall, I need map gas. So that I can turn it upside down and it will still light up. So that's cool. So this aluminum is pretty hot, but not hot enough to expand, I guess. Because nothing is moving. It's going to take a while for that center mass right around the bearing to heat up, I guess. So someone mentioned anger as a tool. I believe that is a that's part of my toolbox. You know, get pissed off and just find a way to get it out. But patience is also a tool. I'm not sure if I have that one or not. I guess we'll find out. Well, guys, I'm running out of patience, so maybe I can tilt that propane bottle to the side. I'm inside of a building, so. Yeah, the sprinklers are going to go off. Fuck. 10.
This way.
It's gonna bend again, but maybe since the aluminum is hot. Coming out. It's not. It's just my contraption is failing. aluminum so hot, but... Shit, here it goes. Ah, the bearing is coming out. Holy shit. So, I got that out, but it's cooled off, so I'm going to have to heat this up again, and hopefully by tapping it, I don't ruin this bearing. I do have an extra, but it was $80 a pop for the bearings, so... really don't want to take a whole lot of chances. And if I use the same contraption to reinstall this bearing, it's going to grip the inner race more than it will the outer. And I don't know if that's going to damage the bearing. shit. It's going in. Heat it up some more. And so this is where patience comes in. I don't have any, so I should ask me, but Jesus, you know, you don't give a fuck, you don't give a fuck. Says C3. So evidently C3, that's the clearance. So you have a little bit of play, I guess, for expansion, that sort of thing. So evidently C3, somebody said that C3 bearings are not for EUCs, but this is a C3 clearance 3 bearing. So C3 means, I think, normal clearance, and then there's C1 and C2 are less than normal clearance. I think it's clearance between the bearings and the races, where the balls, this is a bearing, so the balls and the races, this is FAG 6012 2R SR C3, so 6 on the 6012 means, it's a single track deep groove ball bearing. Other bearings might have rollers, you know, cylinders in there. This one has a deep groove and two races. In between the two races, they're balls, and they're spaced out by this, you know, they're harnessed. I don't know what you call it. But the 012, I think, is a size or something else. And then 2RSR, two red seal. So this is double sealed. 2RSR C3. Yeah, all these bearings, to be able to read the type there, I guess you have to know what you're doing, but Alien Rides are the ones who sold you this. These bearings, so. Right here. Okay, I think it went in a little bit more. Alright guys, next I have to take the seals off and make sure I've got some marine grease that I want to put in there. Or maybe because I don't feel like screwing with it. Holy shit, was this under there all the time? There's a chance that I could damage the seal if I do that. So I could put more grease, but, and I've got the marine grease to do it, but I just don't feel like doing that right now. So, I hope that was